Welcome back to Character Limit Exceeded, the movie review segment where every vice counts.
Oh, I like that. Mm-hmm. We're talking about the 2006 political satire, Thank You for Smoking.
All right, gentlemen, if you're done puffing, it's time to
pick that stick.
Thank you.
I thought you grabbed two.
Man, I forgot about throwing beans all over the floor. This is going to be a thing again.
I got the book report. It's 250 words.
I got a delightful little chirp, 280 characters.
And I will thank you all because I'm going to be smoking it away with the Hemingway. 6 words. Light them up.
Written and directed by Jason Reitman, the man behind Juno and the upcoming sequel to his father's work, Ghostbusters, Thank You for Smoking is a satirical comedy centered around the world of corporate lobbyists. Random fact, one of few movies produced by Elon Musk. Anyway, this is a story of master debater Nick Naylor, portrayed by Aaron Eckhart, a performance that literally landed him the Dark Knight. He comes across cool and confident. You'll be rooting for him so much, you almost forget that he's a despicably immoral character. Just like how Starship Troopers' anti-war message gets lost in buckets of bug blood. The cast is incredible. Just look at this lineup. William H. Macy plays his congressman role with just the right amount of Ted Cruz worminess, making it impossible to sympathize with him. Adam Brody also stands out, delivering some of the funniest lines in his only scene. We follow Edgelord Naylor's escapades until his smooth talking eventually lands him in hot water. He finally realizes how his actions affect his adoring son, his role as a father being the only thing he's not willing to compromise, and the movie ultimately ends with a message of personal responsibility. It's refreshing when a revisited comedy doesn't feel dated. I love how the ridiculous NRA arguments, framed by the lovely David Koechner, have non-ironically been adopted by the current anti-gun control movement.
Now, if a plane crashes on account of pilot error, do you blame the Boeing Corporation? If some booze-besotten drunk runs someone down, do you go banging on the doors at General Motors?
That's a good one.
Thank you.
Just one of the many ways this movie, and its source novel, still bites today.
Jason Reitman expertly rolled this satirical black comedy. The smooth, flavorful blend of characters are portrayed by a non-stop parade of recognizable faces, who play off one another in the most satisfying fashion. Still not convinced? Well, all the cool kids are watching it.
But you can't win that argument. So, I'll ask you. So you think chocolate is the end-all and be-all of ice cream, do you?
It's the best ice cream. I wouldn't order any of it.
Oh, so it's all chocolate for you, is it?
Yes, chocolate is all I need.
Well, I need more than chocolate. And for that matter, I need more than vanilla. I believe that we need freedom and choice when it comes to our ice cream. And that, Joy Naylor, that is the definition of liberty.
But that's not what we're talking about.
Ah, but that's what I'm talking
about. Naylor's redemption is actually America's downfall.
I didn't have to. I proved that you're wrong. And if you're wrong, I'm right.